On the battlefield, a combat lifesaver, or CLS, is the bridge between self-aid and help from a healthcare specialist or combat medic. A CLS is not a medical soldier, but can assist combat medics as well as perform life-saving measures on their own.
I think that CLS is definitely a very important component to bolstering medical personnel and to provide support for us.
Combat lifesavers are just as vital in garrison as they are in theater.
One of the most significant events I think that occurred during my time in garrison was actually a car collision that occurred on the interstate where someone received a laceration to their femoral artery. All it took was two tourniquets, and then civilian EMS came, picked him up, and later I learned that his life was saved. Combat application tourniquets, that's something that all CLS can learn. That would have been sufficient to save that man's life.
To be a CLS, a soldier must first complete the 40-hour course and pass a written test as well as receive a go on a series of performance tasks during live lanes.
Move to cover!
It's important for the combat lifesavers as well as the medics, we do the same thing to have tough, realistic training. In the real world, you have real patients, they're gonna be geared up, they're gonna be heavy, you're gonna have to treat their injuries, you're gonna be getting shot at or blown up, and you're gonna have to get those casualties out of there and yourself safely.
In the exercise, soldiers are required to apply what they've learned in the classroom under fire of paintball guns and under pressure of time.
Putting an NCD in or applying a tourniquet, that's easy when you're sitting in a nice, cool, air-conditioned room. But when you're out on a 250-pound guy and you have to apply a tourniquet to a thigh, and you got to lift that guy up and put him onto a board, I mean, that gives you a real sense of feeling for what's going to happen out in the field. Everyone should have an idea of how to help the buddy next to you. Because I know if I'm the only CLS qualified guy and I'm the one that goes down, what's going to happen?
For the 29th Mobile Public Affairs Detachment, I'm Specialist Nia Patton.